Welcome to a new session. We are going to talk about how to generate a step definition. Okay, so we have our steps here. So we are going to generate a step definition for one of the steps. So let's see, I'll generate for this step. So I want to generate a step definition for normal. There is no argument, there is no example, there is no table, nothing here. Simple. Even user navigate to the login page. When user submit username password, then user should be able to be logged into the application. This is a simple, very simple. And we are going to run from a runner class, which I have explained in the last session. Okay. One thing I forgot in the last session to give you the number of tags we can pass here. We can pass multiple tags by comma at the rate a b c d f anything. Again, you can pass number of tags like this by comma comma comma. Okay, so I'm just passing one, so I want to run only one, generate one step definition. What happened? It's got some error. So what is the error? Method before also should be static. So I have given here, since it's a static, so I'll give public static, and this is also static. Should have, we have got the error, so we can learn this too also. So it should be static. So let me run it again and generate a step definition. Why I have kept these two annotations, before class and after class, which is a JUnit class we have learned in last session. You can go and go through that video and you can come to know like why we have, because we want to execute something before the start of our test suite, and we want to execute something after the finish of our test suite. Example, closing all the open application, closing all Excel sheet or window, anything means Word, closing all the application after execution, how many windows has opened or the Excel sheet has opened. So this is the steps we'll use for that purpose. Okay, so now the step default step definition has generated here. So this is our basically a glue code. You can see it, it's a glue code. Basically there's nothing, only the step has got generated. Now we want to, so this before and after will be default, so we want that to be present. So we'll remove all these things and we'll import cucumber jars. So you can see it, we can import one by one, or you can press Ctrl Shift O to import all at a time. Now your code should be present inside this, whether you are implementing LeanFT or you are implementing Selenium WebDriver, or you are using HTTP client, or you are using JUnit. Whatever you want to use it, you can use it here. Accordingly, step by step, it will execute. So what I'm going to do here, I'm just going to type system.out.println. Okay. And I'm just going to print this step. So we can come to know. So which step we are, so I'm just going to copy paste it. So you can see it again. I'll just copy paste. Okay, I have to copy this one. Now I'm going to run it. So if I run it, what will happen? It will print the message because I'm running the step definitions. Okay, so you can see it. I'm inside a before method. User navigate to login page. User submit username and password. User should be logged into the Gmail. I'm inside the after. So before will execute and then the after will execute. Okay. If I run all the scenarios from this, because already we have generated the step definition, so let me run this all scenarios. So you can see it, If I close and open it again, all this yellow marking has gone, means step definition has been generated. So if I give a tag 1, I can run the tag 1. So this will run for 3 times. Okay. So as I explained you, there is here we have written one line, like given annotation for the JUnit before class, before start of any execution. So let me give here also some input print whether this is our code is going inside this before all or not. So let me write it before all suit. Okay, and then we write before after all suit. So after all suit. Okay. So what will happen? It will execute 1 time this one, then 3 times this all, 3 times, and then at the last this. Before that, for every scenarios it will run, I'm inside before. After running all this, I am inside after. Okay. So let's run it. You can see it. Why it has validated the outcome. Okay, I have given different tags, so I will just give here same ABC, and I'll remove this ABC. So it will run all the scenarios, and I'll give here ABC. So you can see it. If I run it, you can see. So if you want to see the report in a JUnit, you can see it here. Go here. So 3 scenarios, all the steps has executed. 3 scenarios, all the steps has executed. 3rd scenario, all the steps are executed. Now we want to see how the sequence it is print executing. So I told you it will first print. Okay, I'm inside before all suit. Even the start of execution of a scenario, it will print before all suit, which we have given here in the runner class. So any operation if you do inside this method or annotation, it will execute first. Then I'm inside before, user navigate to the login page, user submit username password, user should be logged into the Gmail. I'm inside after. Now second scenario it will pick up. I'm inside before method. Okay, this is the scenario name. It has picked up the scenario name. User navigate to the login. Means what scenario it has to execute. So it has printed like this. User will be logged in into the Gmail. I'm inside after method. Again, before 3rd scenario. I'm inside before method. I'm doing this. Then I'm logged into the Gmail. I'm inside after method. Where it is printed after all. You can see it after all suit. So all the suits has got executed. It has gone into that class and done it. Now to see a report, HTML report, just refresh the project. Refresh it and you can see the report. If you open, you can open here also. You can open in the browser also. You can see all green. Green means all the steps have got executed. If it is red, that step has got failed. Okay, so this cucumber step definition is independent of any tool or any jars. We have not implemented for Selenium, we have not implemented LeanFT, we have not implemented for the web browser, what you call service level testing, we have not implemented the JUnit class. It is independent, we have done it. So I want to show in the next session how to generate the step definition for different type of scenarios. This is a plain scenario we will generate for the outline scenario, how the arguments are coming, how we can use that argument. Then I'll use tables, then I'll use examples. So all this we'll use, whatever we have discussed here, like table, examples, all will use it and generate it. Thanks for watching this video. See you soon.